Well, hey, welcome to the first problem of the day for Calculus 1. We're going to start with a little bit of pre-calculus material, but before we get started, a quick warning that these videos go pretty fast. I edit them down so that they don't take too much time, but I do all of that with the expectation that you'll be hitting pause in your browser when you need to, you'll rewind, you'll rewatch, and you'll go through this video as much as you need to get all the material. So having said that, let's start this first problem. We need to find f of g of 8. What we should do first is find g of 8, because that's in these parentheses. So I'll write g of 8 out here, and the way we're going to find g of 8 is we're going to go down to this graph, we're going to look at x equals 8, and we're going to look at the y value of the function named g. Right here we can see that g of 8 equals 5. Okay, now that we know that g of 8 equals 5, we can replace g of 8 right here with the number 5. Now, to find the final answer for this problem, we need to go back to our graph and look at x equals 5. Then, at x equals 5, we need to find the y value of the function that we call f. And you can see up here that that value is 6. So our answer for this first part of this problem is going to be 6. Let's do it again. We need to find g of f of 9. That suggests that we should be starting this problem by finding f of 9. We can find f of 9 by going down to this graph and looking at x equals 9 and going up to the y value of the function that we call f. And you can see that that y value on this graph is 7. So then we're going to take that 7 and we're going to plug it in for f of 9. That leaves us with g of 7. And to find g of 7, we need to go back to our graph. We look at x equals 7 now, and g of 7 is going to be the y value of this function g when x equals 7. So our y value here is 4, so our answer to this problem is going to be 4. Okay, last problem. We need f of 8. We're going to start by finding f of 8. F of 8 means the y value of this function f when x equals 8. So we go over to x equals 8 on this graph, we go up to the y value of the function we're calling f, and as it turns out, the y value of that function is 8. So then what we're going to do is we're going to take this 8 that we just found, and we're going to plug it in right here, and to finish this problem, we need to find f of 8. Well, we actually already found f of 8. We could go back to the graph and look one more time, but we're going to find that the final answer for this problem is 8. Okay, I hope that this helps you out with this homework problem. I'll see you tomorrow for the next problem of the day.